Welcome to this short introduction to the Slide Master. It's a functionality in PowerPoint that can give consistent and effective setup of your slides. You may already now use your institution's template, or you could choose another template. In PowerPoint, you can find a number of designs. For this presentation, I'll just use this one. When I want to make changes in all slides, in my entire slideshow, I go to this one, View, the Slide Master. The top icon is the most important one. This changes made in this slide affects the entire slideshow. For instance, I would like to change the color, the font color of the heading. Done. Now it's changed in all the layout variations you find below the top icon. The front page or title page, content page, divider, two columns, etc. Changed once here. I may want to increase the font size here, or maybe the bullet. I could change another color for the bullets. I'll go to the tabs I know, home, insert, etc. I still have this new tab, Slide Master, open, but these are also active. Home, go to the bullet setup here. Choose another color, for instance, red. Done. Now the setup has been changed for all slides in my slideshow. Opening the Slide Master tab, closing the master look, I can see how my slides from now on will look. This is a slide with blue heading. The font size is corrected, and we have the red dots. If I enter a new slide, go here, I'll choose this one. The setup will be exactly the same, ready to use. I can also look at other variations of the layout here. Change it to the front page. I could switch divider page, two columns, etc. You can always go back to the former setup. Till now, I have only discussed new slides. Let's see how slides from an existing presentation fits the Slide Master. One of my participants in the course, Sam Sander, well, name is different, affiliation different, we'll just call him Sam. Sam presented himself with these three slides. I'll just copy the slides, enter it here in my presentation, like this. Let's take a look at the three slides, if they fit this new setup and the Slide Master already. Well, it doesn't. You can see the heading is jumping up and down, the fonts are different, etc. Let's take a look at the three slides one by one. I can actually go to layout and see which kind of layout did Sam use. He used title content object instead of a title slide. If I push this one, it will look like this. here is actually an empty slide with a text box on top of it. Let me just try it, see if I can find one. There are a few text boxes here, I can move them around, etc. It's not totally fitting the slide master. Let's see if we can correct it by clicking here. Now it's actually fitting the slide master. Same here. Go with this one. Now it's fitting. Now the headings are not jumping up and down. They're fitting the slide master. We still have a problem, however, with this text. This text is gray and the font is too large. In that case, you may have to open a new slide and rewrite the entire text. However, I recommend that you try out this shortcut first. Start by selecting the text, cut, insert the text in a Word document. Here you can actually see the culprit. There are indents and bullets in the text. Mark the text normal, cut, insert. Now the text is corrected and it's fitting the slide master. Finally, I want to put a logo in all the slides. Go to the slide master, go to the top icon here. I want the logo to be present in all slides. I've taken the logo from Sam's department website. It looks like this. I'll just adjust it to the heading up here. Take care, don't let the title overlap the logo. Now it's fixed. Close the master view and go to presentation mode. All slides will now have the logo. Headings in blue, bullets in color, same font size, etc. Best of all, new slides will have similar look and content with no additional time spent. Other functionalities in the slide master are useful too. So for inspiration and time saving, try it out. Thanks.